Devanarotaman Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Atujayam Vidayet Ashtakai Surapatresu Nityam Bhagavata Sivaya Bhagavati Utam Sluke Bhakti Bhavati Dashtige Om Namo Bhagavati Vasudevaya
Deha Vag
dijam dira. Dharmaya sratayan vitaha. Shipanchagam maharapi. Venu bulmam vivanalam. Tapasa by austerity or voluntary rejection of material enjoyment. Brahmacharyena by celibacy, the first austerity. Samena by controlling the mind. Cha and Dhamena by fully controlling the senses. Cha also Tyagena by voluntarily giving charity to good causes. Satya, being truthfulness. By truthfulness, so chabyam, and by following regulative principles to keep oneself internally and externally clean. Yamena, by avoiding cursing and violence. Niyamena, by regularly chanting the holy name of the Lord. Va and Dehavak, Gudijam, performed by the body, words, and intelligence. Dira, those who are sober. Dharmagya, fully imbued with knowledge of religious principles. Sadaya, anvitaha, endowed with faith. Shipanti, destroy. Agam, all kinds of sinful activities. Mahadapi, although very great and abominable. Venu gulmam, the dried creepers beneath a bamboo tree. Eva like an alarm fire. Translation and purport by Divine Grace, Lesi Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada Ki. To concentrate the mind, one must observe a life of celibacy and not fall down. One must undergo the austerity of voluntarily giving up sense enjoyment. One must then control the mind and senses, give charity, be truthful, clean, and non-violent. Follow the regulative principles and regularly chant the holy name of the Lord. Thus, a sober and faithful person who knows the religious principles is temporarily purified of all sins, performed with his body, words, and mind. These sins are like the dried leaves of creepers beneath a bamboo tree, which may be burned by fire, although their roots remain to grow again at the first opportunity. Please repeat. To concentrate the mind, one must observe a life of celibacy and not fall down. One must undergo the austerity of voluntarily giving up sense enjoyment. One must then control the mind and senses, give charity, be truthful, clean, and non-violent. Follow the regulative principles and regularly chant the holy name of the Lord. Thus, a sober and faithful person who knows the religious principles is temporarily purified of all sins, performed with his body, words, and mind. These sins are like the dried leaves of a creepers beneath a bamboo tree, which may be burned by fire, although their roots remain to grow again at the first opportunity. Purport. Tapa is explained in the Smriti Sastra as follows. Manasastendriyanam cha aikagrayam paramum tapa. Complete control of the mind and senses, and their complete concentration on one kind of activity is called tapa. Our Krishna consciousness movement is teaching people how to concentrate the mind on devotional service. This is first class tapa. Brahmacharya, the life of celibacy, has 8 aspects. One should not think of women, speak about sex life, dally with women, look lustfully at women, talk intimately with women, or decide to engage in sexual intercourse. Nor should one endeavor for sex life or engage in sex life. One should not even think of women or look at them, to say nothing of talking with them. This is called first class brahmacharya. If a brahmachari or sannyasi talks with a woman in a secluded place, naturally there will be a possibility of sex life without anyone's knowledge. Therefore, a complete brahmachari practices just the opposite. If one is a perfect brahmachari, he can very easily control the mind and senses. You see, God and the Thai. If one is a perfect brahmachari, he can very easily control the mind and senses, give charity, speak truthfully, and so forth. To begin, however, one must control the tongue and the process of eating. In the Bhakti Marg, the part of devotional service, one must strictly follow the regulatory principles by first controlling the tongue. Sevon mukhehi jivadu swayam eva sporati adha. The tongue jiva can be controlled if one chants the Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, does not speak of any subjects other than those concerning Krishna, and does not taste anything not offered to Krishna. If one can control the tongue in this way, brahmacharya and other purifying processes will automatically follow. It will be explained in the next verse that the path of devotional service is completely perfect and is therefore superior to the path of fruitive activities and the path of knowledge. Quoting from the Vedas, Sita Viraghava Acharya explains that austerity involves observing fast as fully as possible. Tapasana Sakena. Srila Rupa Goswami has also advised that achahara, too much eating, is an impediment to the advancement in spiritual life. Also in Bhagavad Gita, chapter 6, text 17, Krishna says, Yukta hara vihara shya, yukta chestasya karma su, yukta svapna bhagodasya, yoga bhavati dukaha. He who is temperate in his habit of eating, sleeping, working, and recreation can mitigate all material pains by practicing the yoga system. In text 14, the word dhira, meaning those who are undisturbed under all circumstances, is very significant. Krishna tells Arjuna in Bhagavad Gita, chapter 2, text 14, Matra spasas tu kaunteya sitosna sukha dukada agama paino nitya tam stisekshwa bharata. O son of Kunti, a non-permanent appearance of happiness and distress, and their disappearance in due course, are like the appearance and disappearance of winter and summer seasons. They arise from sense perception, O Sian of Bharat, and one must learn to tolerate them without being disturbed. In material life, there are many disturbances, adhyatmika, adhidaivika, and adhibhautika. One who has learned to tolerate these disturbances under all circumstances is called dhira. So Sukadeva Goswami is speaking this verse, these two verses. Not to a devotee, The next verse after this is to a devotee of Krishna consciousness. It's to a fruity worker. And the proof is here. For one who is not a devotee, artificial austerity, which is a torture to the body, which is a torture to the soul, it is a torture to the super soul. May be temporarily controlled, but the seed of sinful activity will remain. But bhakti, pure devotional service, will not leave anything to be a source of disturbance in the future. Bhakti process has the potency to uproot the seed of sin. Actually, that is Srimad Bhagavatam. So the verse name explains that Srimad Bhagavatam uproot the tree of threefold miseries. He didn't say he cut the tree. Other processes can cut the tree, but the tree will germinate again. But the process of bhakti is so strong that it does not just cut the tree, it will uproot the tree completely with the roots. So there is no question of germinating in the future. The Brahma said that. The Brahma said in Brahma Samhita, he said, I worship Govinda, the supreme personality of Godhead, who is very experienced in doing two things. One, he imposes the result of the activities of those who are sinful upon them. They cannot escape it. And at the same time, he will fry the seed of the devotees, that there is no question of having it to grow again in the future. It is completely fried. That's bhakti. It fries the seed of sinful activities, or it will uproot it completely. No chance of germinating. Other processes does not have this potency. Therefore, practicing austerity, which is not meant for purifying the heart, is not sufficient. Therefore, we see in the scriptures, like this particular verse, talking about austerity. And the next verse is going to discuss. This austerity is not necessary if one is simply taking to Krishna consciousness. That also you find in Bhagavad Gita. But Lord Krishna is not discouraging austerity. Krishna is making a clear distinction about tapo divyam, austerity which is transcendental, and austerity which is demonic. Kapil Muni, he advised all this. He spoke to his mother. Tapasheva param dhotim bhagavanta madukseje sabhabhuta guhavasam bindate anjasa abhuman. Tapasya eva. Austerity is compulsory. It is necessary. It is not an option. It is compulsory. Tapasheva param dhotim. If you want to realize Krishna as Brahman, as Paramatma or Bhagwan, he said the process is austerity. It is certain. And one can overcome this through austerity. In the second canto of Bhagavatam, Krishna himself, he told the Brahma, I created this material world through austerity. I am maintaining it through austerity, and I will destroy it through austerity. Therefore, I am austerity. Without austerity, one cannot get me. And this up there, the advice for his children. Now I am the who the habadam the goke. I am this body. He said, this body is not meant for sense gratification because sense gratification is available to all species of life, not only human beings. Carbon cluster had a tea, bit jam, jay, bit jam. If you look at it very carefully, animals, they gratify their senses better than human beings. If sense gratification is the goal, animals, they do it better than human beings. There is nothing like illicit sex for the monkeys or the animals. They don't have illicit sex in their life and they are not going to be judged for committing illicit sex. The human beings are responsible for illicit sex. So it's better, the monkey or the human being. If we are going to calculate us in terms of sex gratification, the monkeys are better. The pigs are better. They don't go to hospital, even though they eat in the gutter. They don't go to hospital. Human beings are eating the scientific kitchen and they will go to hospital the next day. So Lord Sabdevi said, this body is not meant for sense gratification because animals can do it better than anyone. What this body is meant for, tapa de vam putra ka jena satchas to jay. Sokyam Brahma Sokyam to Anantam. Here he said transcendental austerity. And when Prabhupada was speaking on this verse, he said, don't perform austerity like Hiranyakasipu. That is condemned. Hiranyakasipu, he performed austerity. But what was the result of his austerity? Is to kill his own son, or Lord Vishnu, which is not possible. And he was killed instead. Not that kind of austerity. Transcendental austerity for what? Such as today, the heart must be purified. Austerity is meant for purifying the heart, to purify the consciousness. Therefore, it is said in the Sita Chaitamrita, Boga Tyaga Krishna Pritye. We should give up sense gratification to please Lord Krishna. Austerity is meant to give pleasure to Krishna. What is austerity? Austerity means that one is voluntarily accepting some inconvenience to please someone else, not starvation. Starvation is not austerity. Starvation means you don't have. Austerity means that every facility is available, but one is voluntarily sacrificing that for something higher. That's austerity, to purify the heart. That austerity is required. And to help us to facilitate this, Lord Krishna appeared, and his appearance day is celebrated with fasting, to purification. And all the incarnations of Krishna, they appeared, only Lord Jagannath, only Jagannath, of all the incarnations of Krishna. You have to perform austerity. In Jagannath, no austerity. You simply eat. The reason is to purify the heart. Purify. The heart to be purified from all the contaminations. We have acquired since time immemorial. So that is austerity. For advancement in Krishna consciousness, austerity is necessary. Elementary austerity for those who are neophyte, those who are very, very weak. Prabhupada has given us simple austerity, which is compulsory. No illicit sale, no gambling, no desiccation, and no flesh eating. This is elementary austerity for those who are very weak. Those who want to make, who want to move very fast in Christian consciousness should put extra endeavor in our practice. We should make extra effort in our practice. By following strictly Ekadasi, actually Ekadasi, if one is very intelligent, if you look at all the rules and regulations in Ekadasi, the idea is to tell you, please don't eat on Ekadasi day. Forget about food on Ekadasi day. If you are looking very carefully at all what the Ekadasi rules say, don't eat this, don't eat this, don't eat this, look at it very carefully. It's indirectly telling you, don't eat on the current day, forget it. If it is possible. If it is possible. If you can. If you cannot, then go for the lower side. The higher side is that on the current day, especially for those of us who want to overcome inattentive chanting, Slavati Dr. Kura recommend. You must fast on the Kadasi and Janmashtami completely if you want to overcome inattentiveness in chanting. For those of us who are struggling with chanting, Bhakti Dr. Kura recommend complete fasting on the Kadasi day and Janmashtami. One should not remember food. But if you cannot make it, then go for the second choice or the third choice. There's always a room for everyone in Christian consciousness. That is the beauty of devotional service. Everyone has a space to exist comfortably and gradually make progress. Papa used the word, gradually make progress in Christian consciousness. Gradually. But our gradual progress should not be too slow, because Maya is not taking things gradually. Maya is taking things seriously. So if we are too gradual, too slow, Maya will overcome us. She will take it seriously. And then the next thing here is celibacy. Celibacy. There is two types of celibacy, not only one. Two types of celibacy. The first celibacy is that of brahmachari. The second celibacy is in household ashram. A celibacy in household ashram as well. Not only a brahmachari. So they are first-class householder brahmacharis. The principles are all there in the scripture. So celibacy, Prabhupada mentioned here that there are eight qualities that are enumerated here for a good brahmachari. Oh, a pure sannyasi. The principles are mentioned here. One should not even think of women or talk or look at them. So what does that mean? You close your eyes. It is mentioned here. One should not even think of women or look at them. To say nothing of talking with them. So, to close our eyes in the street, you will fall down. One should not look at a woman means don't look at a woman with interest, for some desire to enjoy or to appreciate. That is looking at a woman. Appreciate means what? That I'm appreciating. I wish this is my wife. or I wish I can have. I can have. This body is so nice. It is fit for me. That is looking at a woman, looking with an interest. It is against the principle of celibacy, against the principle of a devotee in Christian concept. All devotees is against the principle. Because it is an apparat to see a devotee and what is not happy, it's an apparat. So if you look, if you don't look at devotees, either male or female, what is that? It's an apparat. We should appreciate devotee for the purpose of Krishna consciousness. But we shouldn't appreciate devotee for our own gratification. That is an offense against the principle of brahmachari life or the life of a devotee. It's not all right. This is called prescribed brahmacharya. One should not think of women, speak about sex life, dally with women, look lustfully at women, talk intimately with women, or decide to engage in sexual intercourse, nor should one endeavor for sex life or engage in sex life. That's the brahmachari. To be a sannyasi or a brahmachari, and to regret, maybe I made a mistake taking to sannyas, or I'm losing all the beautiful ladies around. Maybe I made a hasty decision. It's against the principle. It's against the principle of brahmachari life or sannyas life. One should immediately consider himself or herself the fallen. Because the process is not a denial or hatred on women. It is an active process which is meant for service, positive service for Krishna. One who is following this principle is a first-class brahmachari or sannyasi. And then it is said he wants to speak truthfully. To speak truthfully. Speak truthfully means one should be straightforward. Duplicity is not the process of bhakti. Therefore, a devotee should be straightforward in his or her dealings, in all our dealings, in all relationships, we should be straightforward. That is Krishna consciousness. That is the life of a devotee. In this way, one can begin the process of controlling the senses, and the tongue is meant for chanting the holy name of Lord Krishna, talking about Lord Krishna, and tasting only Krishna prasadam. Krishna prasadam, prasadam means the food which Krishna has eaten and the remnants. It is not just food that has no untouchable things. It means that Lord Krishna has eaten. That which has been offered to Krishna, Krishna has accepted. The remnant is prasadam. It is meant for devotees. Devotees should take this will be purified. The tongue will be controlled naturally. And then, it's a quotation from Rupa Goswami, Pratyahara. Not taking more than necessary. We should not take more than necessary. Take only what is necessary to keep the body and soul together. Anything more than that, it is a disturbance on the process of bhakti. It will have effects in our practice. That also includes our eating, our sleeping, our working, and our recreation. That our activities should be regulated. That is the point. Everything we have to do in Krishna consciousness is an offering to Krishna. Therefore, we have to check and see how it is offerable to Krishna. By checking to see this, we're very careful in everything that we do, and it will be offerable. And when it is offerable, Krishna will be satisfied, and Krishna's satisfaction will be our success in life. There is no time in our life, either as a karmi or as a devotee, that there will no problem. Problems are always there as far as this material world is concerned, because the material world is meant for them. Dukalayam mambo bhita punar janma dukalayam asashvatam. This is how this material world is meant to be. We cannot check, we cannot change it. The best way to do that is to tolerate. Tolerate anything which is beyond our capacity, you should tolerate it, you should accept it as Krishna's mercy. Use that to make advancement in Krishna consciousness. A devotee should be so trained in Krishna consciousness that will see everything, every single situation as an arrangement of Krishna for our advancement in Krishna consciousness. That is Krishna consciousness. That is saying that what is making advancement in Krishna consciousness. And that is the meaning of transcendence. Transcendence means what? Transcendence means that so many difficulties, all the difficulties that one has to pass through in life will help one to remain yes to Krishna. It will help one to remain Krishna conscious. It will help one to make advancement in Krishna consciousness. That is transcendence. And anything which is making one to be less in Krishna consciousness, that is not transcendence. So transcendental, being transcendental, means that we are looking every opportunity to make advancement in Krishna consciousness. That is transcendence. And to come to this level, we must be seriously engaged in the process of transformation. Because transcendence is the goal, but transformation is the means to attain to that stage. We shouldn't just jump to transcendence. We should be concerned with transformation. Transformation will take us to transcendence. And on that level, every difficulty, every situation is a wonderful arrangement from Guru and Krishna for us to make advancement in Krishna consciousness. That is austerity that we have to practice in Krishna consciousness to uproot the seed of sin. That the end of our life as a devotee will be a joyful celebration of going back home, back to Godhead. Hare Krishna. Comments or questions for 2 minutes.
But where the 88
Yes.
Well, why temporarily?
I explained that in the beginning. Right in the beginning, I said, these two verses are not for devotees, they are for fruitive workers. The next verse is talking about devotees. Therefore, here, temporarily means, Sukadeva Goswami is going to discuss Prayaschitta in this chapter, Prayaschitta, atonement. And atonement, how useful is atonement? It is useless because it will never uproot the seed of the sin. Rather, it will help us to remain a conditioned soul. It will help to pamper our senses. Don't worry, if you do this simple activity, you can do this atonement or counteract it. So it is not useful for a devotee. So after this, Sukadeva Goswami will speak about the transcendent. So temporarily means it is not strong. Other processes of bhakti have no potency to remove the seed. Dry austerity, which is not for Krishna consciousness. Celibacy, which is not for Krishna consciousness. Charity, which is not for Krishna. Anything which is not in Krishna consciousness, they are not in themselves sufficient to make one devotee. Therefore, Sukadeva Goswami used that word, temporary. All right? Hare Krishna. Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Thank you.